Hi, I'm Paul Wells from Agile J. In a previous video, we saw an overview of the benefits of using XText to define your own domain-specific language. In this video, we're going to actually go ahead and see how we can use XText to make a new project, and I'll show you how to start making your own DSL. Right, well, the first thing we have to do is create the projects. So right-click in the Package Explorer, New, Other, XText project, and we give it a name, so I'll call it com Agile J demo, and up here it tells me I've got to match the project name to the language name, so that's com Agile J demo demo language, and I'll give the language the name demo DSL, and I'll give any file, this is the extension that will be applied to any files which are made with this language name, and it's worth taking time to get these right. The generator we're not going to be using this time. Press finish. And then there we go. So it's made two new projects. One is the user interface project, and one is the language project. And it's opened for us a new file called demo.dsl.xtext, and this is where we define our grammar. The file that was opened is an example grammar. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to actually compile it. So this is the XText file. Any .xtext file is a grammar definition, and as was generated for us just now, next to the XText file is the MWE file, and if you right click on that and select run as, you have this option here, MWE workflow. Select that, and it will crunch away for a minute. Now if we look at the console, we can see that we've got this message here saying workflow completed in 15 seconds. The next thing we want to do is to run it, and we do that by selecting in the user interface project the plugin.xml file that opens in an editor. And down here we have the option of testing, launch and Eclipse application. And we just let that start up. Now we have a new empty workspace. Inside here we need a new project. Let's just call it test. And inside here we need to make a file, and we'll call that test.ddsl. Remember, DDSL is the file name extension that we nominated when we ran the wizard. And then inside here, we should have a working editor, and we do. So let's select that space and then control space again. It's prompting for a URI. Let's just give it this one here. Okay, and what else does it want? Let's select type, and it wants an ID, so let's call it Fred. Okay, save that. It's happy, there are no problems, no errors. So now we've seen it run end to end, what I've done is I've commented out the last part of the default grammar which XText gave us, and I've added a new component called Hello World, which is literally just the string Hello World, and I've changed the model to be just one of these Hello World components. So we need to compile the grammar again. So run as MWE workflow and save it, yes. That's now completed. So we go back to the plugin tab, launch Eclipse application. And now, well, this file that didn't have any errors now does have errors. The reason for that being that we've changed the grammar underneath it. So we can delete that line and replace it with hello world. And now that's legal. So we've now defined our own grammar and seen it checked for problems by the new editor that we generated.